Hello everyone, thank you for joining us today. Today's webinar is coming from the World Bank, and specifically we are going to hear for the project Evoke, Engage Your Youth to Develop 21st Century Skills. I'm Anna Cross, Education Advisor here at Moodle HQ, and with me I have William Mano, Consultant and Full Stack Engineer, and Robert Hawkins, the Global Lead Technology and Innovation in Education, both from the World Bank. William and Robert, the floor is yours.
Thanks very much, and welcome everybody. It's great to be here with you this morning. My name is Robert Hawkins. I lead our education and tech, or technology and innovation and education team. What we're going to share with you is a project we've worked on for a number of years. Our team supports our lending operations in countries all over the world, where countries are borrowing to improve teaching and learning through the use of edtech. We provide capacity building, technical assistance, support in the design and implementation of projects, and we also develop frontier pilot projects. And what we're going to share with you is one of those frontier pilot projects called Evoke, which started about 12 years ago when I was in our South Africa office, looking at ways in which to use technology to engage young people where they spend their time, reading graphic novels, in social networks, in game environments, to assess to what extent technology can engage young people to learn about global grand challenges in their communities and take action on those global grand challenges. So William, I don't know if you wanna throw up the slides or the slide showing now. So this is an overview. William will be doing most of the talking because we want to get into the weeds with you, but I'll give a brief introduction and then pass to William for sharing a little bit about how we have used this project to develop innovations around AI, around gamifications, and how we have adapted the Moodle platform to accomplish these goals. Before we start, also please use the chat to throw in any questions you have. We want this to be a dialogue, and at the end, hopefully, we can have a discussion around some of these issues. So again, as I said, Evoke is a project that we started a number of years ago in the bank. It's focused on the use of project-based learning as the pedagogical style. Again, using game mechanics, graphic novel content, and storytelling to engage young people and inspire them to solve global grand challenges. We also have the objective of developing relevant 21st century skills as a result of this process. So we've run this in a number of countries. These are the recent iterations. We ran the initial set of activities in South Africa. We worked with a game designer by the name of Jane McGonigal, who uses alternative reality games. And we thought this was a good genre of games because it involves storytelling. And a large part of what we do with Evoke is around telling stories to engage young people to think about the future and ways in which they can take actions to affect that future, not just for their community, but for themselves. The recent activities that we've done are for out-of-school youth in Honduras around the theme of sustainable cities, for also out-of-school youth in Guatemala on the theme of migration. And in Colombia, the recent activity was on climate change. We've also done activities on peace, on literacy, and on waste in Brazil. And as you can see, the latest iteration, I'll talk about kind of some of the research questions we've asked ourselves. The latest one has been on the use of AI for content and development of storytelling. But we began again in South Africa, looking at how we might use technology as behavioral nudges, engaging young people through these mechanics with the idea that they would spend more time on task through reaching students where they are. And this has proven to be important in our evaluations, particularly for out-of-school youth, and particularly as a result of COVID and hybrid learning, the importance of creating engaging content in a digital format. The next question that we were faced with was, how does technology and project-based learning affect 21st century skills, and the importance of thinking about developing a solution to a problem to develop these skills, as opposed to developing empathy in isolation. You are engaging with the community to understand what are the needs or challenges around forced migration in Colombia or migration in Honduras. When thinking about problem solving, how do you engage with other students on, in this case, the Moodle platform to solve problems? How do you reflect this evidence in a portfolio, which William will talk about? The game mechanics are really important here, and we'll talk a bit more about the game mechanics as well. But how do you incentivize young people to take these actions to complete their work and their activities? After we did the research on 21st century skills, which was a randomized control trial with the University in Colombia, we then looked at how to integrate blockchain technology as a way to transfer real value to students, so that each time they did an activity, they received a token of value. Each time they got an 80% or more on that activity, they'd receive another token, which they could then use in a marketplace as part of the game mechanics that William will share to purchase goods and services. And in the case of Colombia, where we did this, they were purchasing cell phone minutes. And you'll see kind of what they've done with Guatemala and Honduras. We in the examples that William's going to show, we didn't have the blockchain technology, but we still have the marketplace and the digital currency, which we call Evoke Coin game mechanics. And then finally, what we'll talk about, and I think what William will now kick off with, is the idea of how we've used AI to create content. And the images you see here were a result of a creative hackathon where we brought together seven teams of youth from very difficult environments in Colombia to use AI to create a unique story on climate change. And then within the actual implementation of the program, we have used AI for both virtual tutoring to support the students, as well as for assessment of 21st century skills. So let me stop there and pass over to William, who will get into kind of more of the weeds for you on kind of how we have adapted Moodle as a platform, looking at ways in which to open the APIs on Moodle to make it a more engaging environment for young people with these objectives in mind. William, over to you.
Thank you, Robert. And so, hey, everyone, it's a pleasure to be here talking to you. So my name is Yulia Mano. I work with Moodle since 2009, I guess. It's 14 years of experience developing plugins and extending the platform. So I entered in this project to try to make Moodle more engaged and more used to use it for the students and try to implement our game mechanics and our activities inside the platform. So Bob introduced us about the AI-generated content. So we are engaging our students to create some content and answer their activities using AI. But we also using AI to create our content, to generate our resources and our content in general way. So this is a fun image because we are trying to create some characters for our history. And at some point we ask the AI, okay, create a new face, but a smile face. And you can see that they generated the AI generated a completely different face. So it's the AI say to us, okay, we are a totally different person and we are happy. So we can see, and even AI has some problems to generate contents, but yeah, we are testing it and create some new features. Okay. And inside Moodle, and we developed a new type of activity called portfolio, where students can create different type of portfolios. They can write down their stories using the blog format, a timeline format, a mastery format, But the students can comment in the each other's activities. They can market themselves. So as you can see, when I enter the name of the student, I can mention a student like a social network. So this is one of the activities that we developed. But the cool feature here about the AI is that when the students post something and this student didn't receive any feedback, so nobody's commented yet, the AI entered it and tried to answer the student, trying to engage them. So we are starting in enhancing this platform. We call it Alchemy. But the idea here is that not just to give feedback for every student, but maybe engage students that didn't receive any feedback yet and try to engage them and keep writing and creating the portfolio. So yeah, this is another experience. And this is inside a model to do it. The portfolio is a model activity, a common model activity, but AI, it's an external tool that communicates with this activity using the web services. So we developed some endpoints inside in the model part, and then this web service is consumed by the AI and we can generate these answers to the students. Okay, so this is the AI part that we have written inside our model. And about the gamification features, and this is the most part that we developed inside the platform. So we have a lot of implementations. So the idea about the gamification features is, and we can see a lot of plugins inside the Moodle.org site, especially the rank, which I guess it was the first plugin, with gamification features, and this plugin was made by me. And after that, we saw some plugins being developed, like the XP, the game, and the other plugins. So, but what we see in these plugins is that they only delivers a part of gamification. So the students complete an activity, and then they receive some points and build a ranking or a scoreboard. Or the students complete an activity and then receives a badge. So the idea behind the Evoke is to create a complete game experience or a more complete game experience where the users access the content using attractive content, and we use it, they start telling. So the idea here, we have an amazing platform, but our content needs to be good. And then at the end of the day, the content's the king. So our content needs to be engaged for the students. The students needs to have pleasure to study. So we take care a lot about our content. So we created a really attractive content. And then when the students are starting, they started to receive some skills. So we I will present this soon, but we developed a simplified and skills mechanism. It's like the Moodle competence skills, but the Moodle competence skills is a little bit complex. So we simplified this. So inside each course, which we call as campaign, inside each course, we create the skills that will be developed inside this course, like innovation, creativity, and a single. And when the students complete the activities, they will receive some points for these skills. And then we can do something with these skills in the future. And of course, the students can receive some coins when they complete the activities. So, and these coins can be exchanged by some products inside the marketplace. So we have the skill development, we have the coins, and we have the marketplace where the users can exchange their coins with some products. And these products could be a digital asset like a book, or a physical asset like a badge or a church or a pencil, and some products that the students receive in the series. And we created a extended badge system. I can see that Don is here on the chat. I already presented this on the Moodle Users Association, which we extended the badge system. So now we have some extra criteria to deliver badges. So for instance, users can receive badges by receiving amount of coins, can receive badges by developing some skills. So I will present that. So the idea about the game mechanics inside the Evoke is to deliver a full experience a full game experience for the students. They can study, they can develop their skills, receive coins, exchange they and purchase some products with these coins, and unlock some new activities or unlock content based on the coins and the skills. So we try to create a full game or a full engagement platform using the Moodle. So the idea here is to present for you everything we did on the Moodle to make it possible. So this is just a small summary. I will talk about the avatars, coins, skills development, the badges, marketplace, a game level course, which is a course format, and the user passion progress. And this is a user profile page where users can see the skills. So it's translated to Spanish. Mis habilidades is the skills. And we have the badges with the badges criteria. Users can upload, of course, the pictures, but they can choose an avatar. And this is the profile page with all of its data. So the first one is the avatar. When the users click on the actualize avatar or update your avatar link or inside the avatar image, a pop-up or a model, it's shown where they can choose an avatar. We have some set of avatars here available for the students. The idea is to go further with this and maybe have some avatars that the users need to buy or exchange with the coins. So okay, you can use this super amazing avatar, but we need to expend 100 alpha coins to buy it. So like it. So we are trying to think about more in-game experience or in-game products that users can exchange their coins, not just the products inside the marketplace. And we have this Evoke coins. So Evoke coins is really easy to configure inside our platform. When we create a new activity and any type of Moodle activity, it's page 85P, any type of activity, we see in the footer of activity Evoke coins setting. So we can configure this to when the students completed this activity, receive some amount of Evoke coins. So for this case, it's a H5C activity. The users will receive 2 Evoke coins if they complete this activity. So Evoke coins in our platform work with the activity completion. So every activity the students complete, they receive some Evoke coins, and they can do something in the future with these Evoke coins. And I will back to the Evoke coins, but not just with the badges criteria in the marketplace, but the idea is really simple. Complete an activity to receive some coins. It's just it. And the game making and the Evoke coins develop, the skills development, it's another feature. It's similar to the competencies, but it's a simplified version. For instance, inside the course and the teacher, anyone who have access to edit the course has access to the skills management, and they can create any skills inside the course. So here you can see the vision, curiosidade, imaginação, investigação. It's like vision, curiosity, imagination, working, and all. So inside these skills, so the teachers just need to create the skills, and these skills will work with these skills in the activities. So when the students complete the activity, they will receive some skill points for this activity. You can see, and this on this page here. So this is our portfolio settings, because our portfolio has some extra and special powers, as you can see. And for instance, users can receive skills when they submit something, when a teacher comments the work, when someone liked the work, when the student receive a grade. But it's possible to users receive skills when activity is marked as completed. So inside the activity settings, and the teacher can go here and say, okay, if the student completed this activity, they will receive 3 points of vision and 5 points of curiosity. So using this, we can create and this You can create and develop in these skills inside the platform. Users can see all the skills used inside the platform in the profile page. And inside the profile page, they can see some extra data about the skills and what they were working and how can they and how they are developing this. And just to a quick review, we already saw the avatars feature, the coins, and the skills development. So all of this, the students can, the teachers can configure in their activity completion. So activity is marked as completed. The students will receive some coins, and the students will receive some skills, some points of some skills. And we also developed some awesome features about the badges, and I will to here quickly interview, overview about the Moodle default badges. So currently, in Moodle, we have two type of badges. We have the course badges and we have the site badges. Each one with their own criteria. So inside the course badges, we can deliver a badge for the user by these five criteria, which is the manual issued by role. So if someone has a role inside the course, they will receive a badge, like a teacher or a completed student, something else. Then students can receive a badge by complete the course. So when the students complete the course, they will receive a badge. And awarded badges, in this case, if the student receives two other badges, they will receive a third badge. And by activity completion, in this case, if the student complete an activity, they will receive a badge. And by competence, when they achieve a competence, they will receive a badge. And we have a site badges. We have some of the same course badges, like the competence and awarded badges. But we have some extra criteria, like the man completing a set of courses. And so if the student completed, for instance, five courses, they will receive a badge. It's like they completed the program, something like this. Profile completion, if they complete all required profile fields then for to achieve this badge, and by cohort membership, if the student is part of the membership. So Moodle has this modular vision and of allows anyone from the community to build extra plugins that can be plugin inside the Moodle. So we have activity restrictions. Anyone can create an activity restriction plugin. For instance, and to restrict your activity by date, by coins, by anything else. But for badges, you don't have this. You have this, just this hard-coded badges criteria. And if you want to deliver a badge by a special criteria of your organization, you can't do it. So we developed a really awesome feature inside the Evoke, which is this extended badge mechanism. So let's imagine that we have the badge A, and the criteria to deliver this badge is the users need to access the course by 5 days. So if a student access the course by 5 days, they will receive a badge. So you can use this badge system to try to engage the students. So if the student access in the first day, they will receive a badge. 5 days in a row, another badge. If the student has access the course by a month, okay, you are amazing students. You totally complete and get this badge. And another scenario is to obtain points. So if, for instance, in this the student receive and will receive the badge B if they obtain 5 points. So you can give the students 5 points in the first activity, and then they will receive 5 coins, they will receive a badge. So students will start to learn inside the platform, and we start to receive a lot of engaging or small coins, small badges, and small incentive and small prizes. So, and we also extended this badge system to not just deliver badges using some criteria that we define, but also combining these criteria. So let's imagine the badge C. To receive the badge C, the students need to access the course by 10 days and also obtain 100 coins. So we can create a mix of plugins, a mix of badges with mixed criteria. So for instance, the badge D, the students need to receive 400 points. They need to receive achieve the level 5 in the block game and complete the activity X. So the idea here behind this badge excellence system is to extend the badge and allow us to create more engaging and creative badges. So here in the profile page, we can see we have two badges in here, the Ciudadano Productivo and the Visionario Creativo. So to receive the first badge, the students need to access the course. So you can see that it's 100% completed. So the students already access the course by the required days and they already receive the coins. And the second badge, the students need to get some skill points. So it's another criteria that we developed. They need to have a sum of all skills. And it's almost, I guess, a 30% completed. Okay, so the idea is to extend the Moodle badge. So inside, even using the Moodle simplified Moodle badge system, the students don't know what is required. They're not clear what's required to receive the badge. So the student needs to complete the activity to receive this badge. Okay, I will receive this badge, but when? I don't know. So in our profile page, users have this feedback, this visual feedback. They can see all criteria, all badges, everything on this page. And I proposed this to be a Moodle Users Association project to be part of Moodle Core. And this is the link in here. It was not approved of the last interaction. But maybe, I don't know, we can work together to make it part of Moodle Core or just deliver it as extended Moodle plugin. I don't know. And all of this works as a local plugin. So we don't need to change the Moodle source code. We don't need to change the car. We just need to plug in this plugin. We just need to install it and everything will work. So yeah, here you can see the tracker link with all its specifications, with all features of our implementation. So maybe this could be a good feature for Moodle or even a external plugin that we can develop on Moodle website. Okay. And the marketplace. So as I said, some plugins like the ranking that I developed, the game, the XP, and the students receive some coins or some points, and the plugins creates a leaderboard for the students, but it's just this. The students can't do anything with their coins, with their points. So the idea behind the Evoke is to create a continuous flow of students study, receive points, receive coins, exchange their coins by products, and back to study to receive more coins, buy something else to back to study, and do this every time. So we developed a marketplace inside the Moodle. This is also a local plugin, and teachers or site administrators can create the products, can create some products. We have some course exclusive products, or we have a site-wide product. So the site-wide product is showed for students from all courses, and the exclusive course product is just displayed for users for this course in specific. So we can create at this point some digital assets like books, an image, a token, something else. And we can also webinars. We have some interviews with mentors. The students can exchange their coins with 1 hour of talking with the mentor. So we have this digital product, but we also have physical products, like we can see a bag, a notebook, and here we can see the amount of products in stock. We can see how many coins students need to have to buy this product. And they can just click on in buy products and they can proceed with the purchasing. So yeah, The idea is, as I said, to create a continuous flow where the students will be engaged to keep studying. They will start to receive coins, to exchange coins probably by something, and they will collect some feedback about this, and they sit back to starting to keep studying, keep going coins, keep developing the skills, and creating interesting products. So this is a really simplified image of our marketplace. We have some reports inside that, like we purchase by one-offs, most purchased products and things like that. But for us, in this presentation, I think the cool feature is here. And where the users can simply, just one click, the users can purchase the product. And here we have the most recent project that we worked, which is our new course format. And the idea here with this course format is to provide some easy way to navigate through our activities and to deliver more visual feedback of progress, of the hierarchy of sections. I can see that Moodle 4.4, I guess, we will have subsections finally, and here you can see the subsections implemented. So we have the session one and the last two active sections, like the Explorer to Comunidad, you follow through there. And those two activities are subsections of the two sections are subsections of section one. So here we can have this radial progress of the progress inside this section. We can add images for each section, so students can customize the path and use some images. And when the students click on the eye icon here, they can see the amount of activities inside each section and the progress. So you can see the hopper from there with one activity and 100% complete. And you can see visually that the students already completed the general sections in this section one, and they have completed a half of the Explorer Comunidad. So the idea on this, and this is a course format. So the idea here is to provide some visual feedback and in an engaged and really cool and easy to see course format where the students can see the sections and everything else. So we also, as we have a simplified course section, a simplified course visualization, we also display the blocks at the right side. And so this is fixed. And you can see the user profile part, but users can exchange the profile by avatars. Just click on the image. The users can see the amount of people coins. And at this case, I have no one. And this is why I'm in the site administration. But the users will see the amount of Evo coins that they have. They can access the profile page or my progress in the link, and they can directly access the marketplace to exchange the coins for some product. We have some scoreboard in there, and we split the scoreboard in three parts. We have the weekly, the monthly, and a global. The idea to split this is to engage more the students. So let's imagine a student that it's offline by 1 week, and then they access the platform, did three activities, and it's on the top of this weekly scoreboard. So the idea is to engage this student to keep working, keep studying, and keep going, achieving and getting more coins and points to be on the top of the monthly scoreboard and maybe in the top of the global scoreboard. So we split the scoreboard in three parts, trying to engage more students. And we have the badges and displayed in the course page easily to maybe engage more students. So the students can see all badges and in a grayed color and for badges, because the badge is not achieved yet. But when they use it, actually the badge, they will see the badge color. So yeah, the idea here is everything we did here is trying to engage more the students, trying to facilitate it and it's comprehensive. It's view of the course, so it's very easy to navigate, easy to see course and activities and sections, but also easily view all features that they can achieve or all benefits in an easy way. So you can see the coins, you can see the scoreboard, you can see very simply everything. And I don't know if I talk a little bit fast, but everything to resume was built on top and was built using the most advantageous mode of Moodle, which is its modularity. And so we did everything. We created an extended theme. We created everything using local plugins, the marketplace, the badge systems, the skills system, and everything. We created activity restrictions. So students can access the activity only if they achieve some points in some skill, or students can access this activity only if they have some coins. We also developed a activity restriction where the students need to buy a activity by coins. So for instance, then the students only can print the certificate if they have 100 coins. So they need to purchase the certificate with the coins. So we also have this activity restrictions based on skills and coins. So we also created some blocks, as you could see the benches and the scoreboard. And we created activities like the portfolio activity. We created this course format to simplify this, view these subsections in images and progress. And we also created some reports. So everything we did inside our Evoke platform was done by using extra plugins. And because we did this, we don't need to change any part of Moodle core. And anyone who wants to use our plugins just need to install it on their Moodle and it will work. So, and this is a good part of Moodle, and we take advantage of this. We developed everything by using some custom plugins, and we just need to plug and play, and just plug in the plugins and plug the plugins. And everything will work on any platform. So we don't need to change the source code. And this makes our lives easy, because when we want to upgrade Moodle for the most recent, we don't have the pain to change any part of code, and anything will break, everything will work. For instance, I upgraded one of our platforms yesterday for the most recent to the 5.3, and everything works well. So yeah, we take some advantages of usage of modern modularity by just creating external plugin and say avoiding to change any part of code. Okay. So this is all that I want to talk to you, and I hope you enjoy it. And thank you. Any questions?
Thank you. Thank you so much, William. Well, we have some interesting discussions in parallel in the chat. I'm not sure you were able to watch them, but it is Don and Luigi who are trying to find ways to revive the badge suggestion, the MUA project, the MUA project, and have some interesting thoughts. I have to say that I'm very impressed with the work you have done. I love that you've built a whole gamification mechanic using badges, improving badges. The skills were awesome as well. The monitoring of the progress, really amazing. And as Luigi says, I guess everything is possible with Moodle. I have one question. You said that the plugins are available and all people have to do is basically install them in their Moodle installation to use them. Are they available through the Moodle plugins directory?
The plugins are not available in Moodle plugins directory yet. And we first tried for the badge system, we first tried to make it part of core, because we find that this is more, we achieve more people, because for instance, let's imagine that this feature could be part of Moodle 4.4. So everyone who have Moodle will have this by default. And by using external plugin, though, they just need to have a notion that this is possible, find the plugin, the Moodle directors, and then install and use it. So this is because this is why we first our first approach was to try to propose this as part of core.
Embedded then, in the core.
It would be core. But it was not possible yet.
But it makes sense.
But it's not possible yet. But if not possible, we can maybe try another path and deliver it as a Moodle plugin in Moodle.org page. The cool idea is all criteria that we have in this extended badge system are sub plugins. So Moodle don't have criteria as sub plugins, but inside our plugin, we have sub plugins like the cursor certificate or the Moodle certificate that we have extra fields for the certificate. And all of these features are extra plugins. And inside the course, inside our badge system, all of criteria, it's a sub-plugin. So anyone from the community can create their own criteria to deliver badges. So yeah, maybe we were discussing this yesterday, how we will and when we will start to publish the plugins on Moodle World, because we want more engagement from the Moodle community. Plugin developers or Moodle core developers. So, and the way to have this engagement from the developers is publishing the plugins in the Moodle.org and waiting for the code. So, yeah, it's not yet, but we are planning to do it at least starting by the.
It makes sense. And basically, Don has some relevant questions about how can we. I guess all and the Moodle community, how can we play test this gaming environment and how can we install it and where can we install it from and how can we modify it for new gaming projects? So, you have partially answered on this. It needs to be somehow shared with a wider audience so you can get infos from the community.
Yeah, I don't know how to answer you because our campaigns are closed for some users. Maybe Bob Robert can answer you if you can maybe create a platform to be tested by everyone from the community. I don't know if this is possible, but yeah. At least for our plugins, we started to plan and then thinking how we can publish it to be more engaging and to receive this attention and engagement from the Moodle core and community plugins. So, Bob, do you have notion if the public can access a test platform and to test the plugins and maybe collect some?
Yeah, no, that would be fantastic. I mean, again, if as a result of this, Anna. We can set up a test platform that can be kind of a sandbox that the Moodle developer community can play with, begin to develop their own courses and campaigns and provide feedback to William. That would be phenomenal. We're also looking at kind of a course builder to support onboarding new partners. So that might be something we could look at together. One of the challenges that we're trying to work through is integration of the storytelling in the actual course itself. Right now we have a four chapter arc that is explore, imagine, act, and communicate as kind of the structure for the project-based learning curriculum, where kind of the story unfolds during various aspects. The voice of the character comes out in the introduction of the activities. So there's specific kind of story elements ingrained there. And then as you saw in our last iteration, we actually used AI to create new stories as well as provide kind of bots in the form of the characters. So again, this aspect of integrating the story into the learning experience is something that we're still experimenting with, but it could be another area to explore. Everything is, I think, William, it's all now up on our latest GitHub repository. I don't know the process of transferring it to Moodle, but we're open to sharing this in whatever way is easiest for the Moodle community and the developers. And if we can get feedback and onboard additional teachers, partners that want to develop campaigns, that would be fantastic.
I think that Moodle.org should be probably the first place where you can share links to your work so others can work and start seeing. Don says that my son is in a BA program on sustainable development, and he loves storytelling, game design, and adapting Dungeons and Dragons process to SDGs. How can he experience this Evoke gamification and develop a scenario for Thailand issues? So I guess it seems that well, the least I can say for Don is that contact details, the emails from Bob and William are shared in this presentation at the beginning. So you can definitely contact them directly for further information. And thank you for also for the link to the GitHub. So everybody that knows how to use and download one of the plugins can be found in this github.com/evokenet. Also, Don asks if he can share in the Moodle Mood Japan in February 16-18, if they can share your slides at that conference. So I'll leave this, please, Bob, if you want to.
No, I was just going to say absolutely. I mean, whatever we can do to help, it would be fantastic. And, you know, one thing, William, we can think about maybe with the Moodle community and your son, Don, is, you know, maybe launching some type of hackathon where we can bring a number of interested partners together to kind of create their own campaigns. But it'd be great to get your feedback on kind of what you see as the needs and how we can help the community over.
Well, what can I say now? This is really impressive. I wasn't expecting that from a Moodle Academy webinar, but truth is that such kind of webinars do bring us closer, and we can make together really interesting things. Don is sharing his email through the chat. Meanwhile, we are reaching our time, and I think it's time to wrap up this session. So if you have enjoyed this session and Moodle Academy, you may consider getting involved further and help us grow by contributing to its development. Just before closing the session, I would like to remind you that everybody can be an active member of Moodle Academy. You can suggest topic ideas, what would you like to see us covering in the future, and you can join the Get Involved course and make your own suggestion, ask the subject of your interest, vote the subjects that have been already suggested, and you can also contribute to webinars if you have a particular skills and if you are an expert on a subject and you have something interesting to say. Note that webinar presenters will gain presenters badge from the Academy, and you can also contribute to courses by sharing your expertise and contributing to course development, and this way you may gain a course builder badge. Finally, be aware that you can also help us in the Academy, translating the courses into your languages and make Moodle Academy more inclusive. Of course, please help us spread the word about Moodle Academy and the Moodle Educator Certificate, telling your friends and colleagues about the courses offered and lead to badges. And don't forget to take the Are You Ready for the MEC quiz? And if you're ready, contact one of our certified service providers to support you through the Moodle Educator Certification process. Up to here, I would like to thank Robert and William for the very interesting presentation. And I'm sure that we will hear many more later around this Evoke and this gamification approach. Thank you so much.